Welcome to SmackDown Live, folks. And in this SmackDown Live episode, we have Aiden English. I'm gonna get copyright noticed for this. But if that wasn't there, we have Aiden English in his new attire after Simon Gotch got released from the company due to certain circumstances. But we do have a clip that we need to show you guys, and it is from a WWE live event a few nights ago, and Dean Ambrose, Aiden English, and Shinsuke Nakamura were in a tag team match. They were going to go up against the tag team champions, John Cena and Chris Jericho, but the Dean Ambrose and CM Punk attacked them. I will show the clip right now. Folks, we have Paul Heyman out here attacking Aiden English. I don't think that was supposed to happen. But Aiden, this match is apparently underway. But that clip looked brutal. I was there live. I was backstage. I just saw the attack there. I saw the attack from Ambrose, the Shinsuke, and just the attack in general. The referee is recalling this matchup, and everything is okay now. And now, Aiden English is going after Ambrose. That was a little fuzzy beginning there, but that clip that we just showed a few minutes ago, and we'll show it again sometime this show, when Shinsuke appears, but Shinsuke and Aiden were like, okay, let's form a team to win the tag team championships, and we can go on from there, right? And then, just out of nowhere, Dean Ambrose and CM Punk just came out and attacked both of them. And then afterwards, Dean Ambrose and Shinsuke Nakamura attacked Shinsuke Nakamura, but then Aiden English came to the help. So this feud will be settled at SummerSlam when Aiden English and Shinsuke Nakamura take on Dean Ambrose and CM Punk, and the winner of that becomes the number one contender to the tag team championships that both, that Chris Jericho, Cena, Rusev, and Christian hold as of this moment. But this match is for Aiden English to get his revenge on Ambrose. And now Aiden English is showing a pretty hard display right here against Ambrose. He's showing a new side of him we never saw in Von Villains. Huge elbow drop to Ambrose. And it looks like Aiden English has Paul Heyman at his side. That could get pretty interesting for English here. Because Paul Heyman has helped CM Punk advance. He has helped Curtis Axel advance. He has helped everyone that he mentored. He helped advance in the WWE. And will it be the same for Aiden English here? I have no idea. But Aiden English looks to be pretty vicious. I don't know if that's the word, but he looks to be pretty vicious now. Viciouser than before. He was a great talent, part of the Von Villains, and we never saw the Von Villains on In the New Air. Because we were going to have him, but Simon Gotch unfortunately got released. So we weren't able to properly display them and their talents. Now we have Aiden English showing off as much as he can against Ambrose. Oh my god, Ambrose. Aiden English face buster. Got buster face buster. Now Ambrose goes for a pin on Aiden English. 1, 2. Oh my god, Aiden English kicks out at a vicious two count. Now Aiden English tries to recover on Ambrose, but finds out what he was doing, stops him immediately. Now Ambrose, oh, just hitting the shit of Aiden English. And a huge kick. Now punches to the head. And later tonight, folks, there's an open challenge to Cesaro's title. And the person, if the person beats Cesaro, they will become the number one chicken tender for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship at SummerSlam. It could be any Raw or SmackDown talent that comes out here tonight. We have basically every person Raw and SmackDown out here are at SmackDown backstage. I wonder who will accept Cesaro's challenge and if they will fight for the title at SummerSlam. Because it's a possibility. Cesaro won the title at Money in the Bank by beating none other than Apollo Crews after he beat Dolph Ziggler. After Dolph Ziggler beat Shinsuke Nakamura. Both Dean Ambrose and Aiden English having a pretty tough fight right now. Oh gosh, Dean Ambrose looks like he's trying to come back. No, but Aiden English able to move that side away. Now he goes for stops on Ambrose. Stops, just completely stopping Ambrose. Now Aiden English, huge show. Oh my God, English drags Ambrose to the middle of the ring. Oh God, I have no idea. Come down, Mom. Tried for something there, but Dean Ambrose able to reverse. But here comes Aiden English, huge suplex. Aiden English, top rope. Oh my God, what the heck? Aiden English, middle rope now, and now that's a wrap. It's not a wrap. That's a wrap! It was almost a wrap! But Dean was able to reverse. Now Dean was dirty deeds! Dirty deeds to Aiden English. But Aiden English able to somehow kick out after the dirty deeds. Now it was a huge kick. Now it was huge punches to Aiden English's head. But here comes Aiden English, stunner! Huge slam, and now Aiden English, top rope! He goes for a huge butt slash! Now he goes up again! Now he goes up again! Now DMers, Irish Whips, Aiden English, with the corner. Aiden English now able to reverse. No! Aiden English, huge uppercut. Now he goes for the cover on Ambrose. One, two, Ambrose gets out at a 2 count. Aiden English showing off. Is that a smart idea though? Is the question. Oh! Aiden English tried for diamond, luxurious elbow drop, but here comes Dean Ambrose, dirty bulldog, is that it for Aiden English? One, two, oh my God, we never saw Aiden English this resiliency, never saw him have this resilience here tonight, we have never saw him with this much strength. It looks like there's a totally new Aiden English here. But don't forget, this new Aiden English got beat up by Dean Ambrose and CM Punk. So did Shinsuke Nakamura. So, Aiden English does have weak spots, but will Dean Ambrose be able to find it again, is a question. He slapped Ambrose's chest. Amber's able to break his way out of the hold from Aiden English. Oh my god, Aiden English though still capitalizes. Not huge. Far away slam, or whatever the heck that's called. Two. No! Before Aiden pushes the referee out of the ring! Oh, Paul! Davis is mad at the ref!
Whoa.
No! Aiden English capitalizes! Aiden English capitalizes off of the distraction from Heyman! Oh my god! That distraction from Heyman basically just won! English is back unless Davis can come back! Oh, Aiden English! Top! Rope! There he goes for the set swanton! But Amber's able to reverse it, but here comes English! Aiden English just bragging about how good he is. Now Aiden English, they probably even just stand there on the outskirts of the ring. A huge kick to the gut of Amber's. You just need a face. Now, Aiden English running DDT. Amber's is busted wide open. You just see the blood running down his face. Oh my god, this match has been main event caliber matchup. Paul Heyman just sticking on the outskirts of this ring. Now, Aiden English kicking Amber's. For the dirty deeds, but Aiden English reverses into the roll up, but then Aiden English is able to reverse out the roll up. Oh my god, so much happened so quickly in this matchup. Oh, I think Dampers is trying for the dirty deeds. Oh, dirty deeds. Yeah, he was able to pick up the victory over Aiden English here tonight. It looks like Aiden English wasn't able to pick up the W. Oh my god. Yeah, he was picking up the victory over Aiden English. Oh my god. Looks like Diablos does have Aiden English's number. Oh my gosh. Wait, what? And now it is time for Cesaro's open number one contendership match challenge. And we have the world heavyweight champion Cesaro entering the ring. And let me just discuss this, the stipulations, if you did not understand them earlier. This is an open challenge. Any superstar from Raw or SmackDown can respond to it, since Cesaro is a multi-brand superstar. And he is accompanied by the SmackDown GM. But if the other competitor wins this match, then he gets the number one contendership for the title at SummerSlam. So just say John Cena came out. It would be if John Cena won, then John Cena vs. Cesaro at SummerSlam for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. This is not for the championship here tonight. It's just to find who accepts the challenge that faces at SummerSlam if they do win. So we're gonna see who that person is. No. I just see sides of the crowd. Yeah, the crowd just leaked it. Oh my god! It's Ty Dillinger! Holy crap! I did not expect to see Ty Dillinger here tonight. He has the club with him! He has the Baylor club with him! So Perfect 10! He's trying to make the World Heavyweight Championship a Perfect 10! Ty Dillinger and the Bella Club, Raw Superstars! I knew we were going to get a SmackDown Superstar! But we have SmackDown vs. Raw here tonight on SmackDown! I cannot believe it, folks, but SmackDown's about to be made into a Perfect 10! Oh my. The crowd go crazy for the perfect 10. Ty Dillinger. Oh my god, will Ty Dillinger be able to win his way into the SummerSlam match after losing the number one contendership matches for the Intercontinental Championship? But that today he gets an opportunity for the, oh my god, World Heavyweight Championship. Now, Ty Dillinger, no. He punches the wrong jam! He's just fighting the wrong jam right now! Oh my god, how is that even allowed? Usually. Oh my god. But if Ty Dillinger wins, does that mean the World Heavyweight Championship is a Raw title? Oh, that'd be detrimental to the SmackDown brand. Ty Dillinger now going after Cesaro, but Cesaro able to reverse. But Ty Dillinger, the newest member of the Baylor Club, and also confirmed for SummerSlam. Finn Balor versus Seth freaking Rollins, another Raw match. But don't worry, we do have a decent match. SummerSlam matches, as of the recently announced CM Punk and Dean Ambrose versus Aiden English and Shinsuke Nakamura. We also made, we are going to have a US Championship match at SummerSlam, but we are going to have a Samoa Joe versus Kevin Owens to find out who that number one contender is, spot is going to. Because Samoa Joe attacked Nick's Power, the United States Champion at SummerSlam, I mean, a week ago on SmackDown, for no apparent reason. And Kevin Owens wanted that championship shot, so it's going to be a number one contendership match for the U.S. Championship tonight on SmackDown as the main event. So tonight we are mainly fighting the contenders, you know, of the titles. We're making stuff happen, you know? Oh my god. Ty Dillinger, man. He's putting it all out there. You're also gonna see Tyler Breeze and Undertaker at SummerSlam fighting each other for the WWE Championship. That's gonna be a pretty insane match because we have the gorgeous Tyler Breeze, the person who beat John Cena, fighting the dead man, the man of 24-2. Will Tyler Breeze be able to walk out SummerSlam the WWE champion and go back home with that wonderful title of his that he won from Cena? Cena won from Booker T. So yeah. Kick to the arm of Ty Dillinger. Now Ty Dillinger's down. So I was trying to capitalize. And he does not want to defend his title at the SummerSlam pay-per-view. We got 2 more weeks until SummerSlam, which is going to be pretty insane. We got 1 more SmackDown, 1 more Raw. And I'm excited to find out how the Sami Zayn and Mark Henry rivalry plays out. Because I have a feeling that rivalry match at SummerSlam is going to be pretty intense. Or maybe a perfect 10. Whatever you like to call it. And at Raw, there will be another SummerSlam match announced shortly for Raw. It's going to be one of those best of 5 matches. And it starts at SummerSlam and ends at the next pay-per-view, which is Hell in a Cell. So that is going to be absolutely insane. I cannot wait for the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view because they're going to be pretty insane matches, you know? Ty Dillinger now going to the top rope. Now, perfect 10 splash! Perfect 10 splash One, two, but so it would have break his way free of the perfect dead splash. And now he just elbow drop to Cesaro. Zachary Aza, the SmackDown GM, and Ty Dillinger with the Baylor Club. Carl Anderson, Luke Gallows, and of course Finn Balor. And Finn Balor, as I said, fighting Seth Rollins at the pay-per-view. And the club are currently not booked for anything yet, so that's going to be interesting to see who they will go up against, if anyone that is. Oh, Sami Zayn has been pretty, I don't want to be speaking out about Raw, but that's because we got Ty Dillinger here. But Sami Zayn and Mark Henry has been a feuding rivalry so far. On Raw, Mark Henry attacks Seth Rollins and brought him out to the ring to beat Sami Zayn. And just beat up Sami Zayn afterwards with the bear hug. And the world's strongest slam in the inside of the ring. So that rivalry match is going to be intense. Hopefully it doesn't have Seth Rollins or Finn Balor involved in it, but probably not, since they have a match later on in the night. And now Ty Dillinger, perfect 10 neckbreaker. The crowd's chatting, tend to go crazy. And Ty Dillinger, the fireman's carry neckbreaker. And Ty Dillinger drags his Oh, he's going for the perfect 10. The perfect 10. Knee. Easy. No, he almost hit it, but Cesaro able to move it. No, Cesaro capitalizes with the finisher move. But no, Ty Dillinger able to break his way free. Now he tries for a dropkick for Cesaro. For Cesaro. Oh, Cesaro goes for the neutralizer. The neutralizer! Oh my god, I did not think he was going to see that. But here comes the Battle Club. The Battle Club. Interfering on Cesaro. So he tries to pick Ty Dillinger up. Oh my god. Cesaro picks Ty Dillinger up. Huge slam. So it still looks distracted from the club though. He thinks he has it. One! Two, no, it wasn't a 10 count. Now Cesaro picks up Ty Dillinger. And Cesaro takes a look at the club before suplexing Ty Dillinger. But Cesaro takes a look at the club! And here comes Ty Dillinger. Ty Dillinger rolls Cesaro up. After a massive reversal, rolls him up. One, two. No. Cesaro will break his way free. Oh my god, another one. Another perfect 10 roll up. Two. Cesaro kicks out once again. Oh my god, here comes Ty Dillinger! Neckbreaker to Cesaro, doesn't exactly fully capitalize, but still brutal. Ty Dillinger goes for the 10 elbows. Looks like he's going to divide that 10 by 2 though, and hit 5 massive elbows, or maybe just 2, divide that by 5 actually. And 1! 2! Dano! Ty Dillinger kicks out. He wants to make the championship a perfect 10. This might have to be the main event, folks. Match is going on longer than anyone may have expected. Cesaro thought probably Fernando or Diego, but freaking Aiden English before the makeover was going to come out, but I guess not. Now Cesaro trying to hit the stomach of Ty Dillinger. Cesaro looks a little bit distracted from the club though. Looks like he's not his peak pull performance right now. A huge kick to the knee. And now Carl Anderson. And now Carl Anderson. Just as I said, doesn't look like he's in peak pop shape. Cesaro. But he, Ty Dillinger tries to look up Cesaro, but Cesaro capitalizes. One, down, Ty Dillinger able to kick out. Uppercut, not elbow, uppercut. That's a no. Doing it all 3D. No, time for Dillinger. Dillinger to get up. But Dillinger reverses. Oh! No! Perfect 10! Get the perfect 10 is almost flying. The perfect 10, is that enough to put Snow down? One! Two! Three! Ty Dillinger is the number one contender for the World Heavyweight Championship at SummerSlam! Oh my god! Oh my god.
Here's your winner, the perfect 10!
Ted! The crowd's going crazy for Ty Dillinger, so is the club! Zachary Easer looks disappointed at Cesaro. That Cesaro lost this matchup for SmackDown. They just had a Raw Superstar win a SmackDown match. Never thought that would happen in 1,000,000,100,200,400,300,400 years. Oh my god. And for the main event of SmackDown, we are here playing Kevin Owens versus Samoa Joe. And this match has been made last week when Samoa Joe attacked Nick's Power after Nick's Power beat Kevin Owens. And this match is here to find out the number one contenders for the US Championship. It's gonna be great. I can't wait to see who's the number one contender, because the winner will fight Nick's Power at WrestleMania. I'm not WrestleMania. Oh my god, I'm like fucked right now. The winner of this match will fight Nick's Power at SummerSlam for the United States Championship. And it's gonna be pretty insane. I'm pretty excited for this match. So now let's get Samoa Joe out here right now to even out Kevin Owens right now. Both are professionals in the ring with fighting and brawling. It's what Samoa Joe is known for, being a destroyer, being a life career ender. And it's gonna be pretty great, as I said before. And this match is gonna be really hype. Now Samoa Joe gets ready, and so does Kevin Owens, and the bell rings. And a huge German suplex. Now Samoa Joe taking up Kevin Owens, but Kevin Owens able to reverse with a huge neck breaker. Now Owens grapples Samoa Joe. How is Kevin Owens even going to get this big man around at all? Kevin Owens huge kick to Samoa Joe's back, and now Samoa Joe gets picked up by Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens is just showing great offense here tonight. Now Owens is going for the KO elbow. Now Samoa Joe able to capitalize on his advantage there with Kevin Owens. Now Samoa Irish whip, Kevin Owens huge boot. Now Samoa Joe another huge boot. and a huge tribute suplex to Kevin Owens, and now Samoa Joe's in full effort mode right now. He's trying to knock out Owens, but then Owens just got hit by, got hit by Samoa Joe. Now Samoa Joe trying to injure that arm of Kevin Owens. Now a huge kick from Kevin Owens. Now for Samoa Joe.
You can see the results from that move. You'd have to think that Kevin Owens' brawling style makes him incredibly difficult to game plan for. He might be trying to take out
Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens tried as hard as he can to actually knock out Samoa Joe here, the big man. Yeah, huge kick. It's Samoa now. Kevin Owens, huge, just rolls him over now. Trying to hurt the head of Samoa Joe, but Samoa Joe able to reverse it to an elbow.
Classic offense here. Yeah, that's when he's the most dangerous. Matt Cole, this is just great offense by Samoa Joe.
Now Samoa Joe, huge kick. Now he tries to pick up Kevin Owens, but Kevin Owens able to reverse with the knee. Samoa Joe now Irish whip to Kevin Owens. But Kevin Owens is able to reverse and knock Samoa Joe off his feet.
He'll need to find a way to turn things around here. Wow,
now huge elbow. Elbow. Now Kevin Owens is trying to make Samoa Joe tap the freak out.
And somehow he's got to take the pressure off his neck. And he escapes the hole.
And now Samoa Joe, huge kick to Kevin Owens' back. Back has been Saints Mojo just dragging Kevin Owens on the top rope, and what could he be going for here? Huge! Oh my god!
Guys, this is where we find out what he's made of.
Well, this might finally be where one of these guys starts to pull away.
But Owens able to still move and reverse. But Samoa Joe, here he comes, he's coming back. Now, Samoa Joe suplex to Owens. Now Samoa Joe. Kevin Owens sweeps a leg. I thought Samoa Joe was trying for something brutal there. But I guess not now.
My god, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack. And I hope we can get a doctor.
Now Samoa Joe trying to hurt the shoulders of Kevin Owens. Now Samoa Joe goes for a cover on Kevin Owens, but Kevin Owens reverses.
Can you believe what he's withstood here tonight? Oh, here he comes.
Mojo taunts Kevin Owens.
Intimidation there. Really pushing his opponent to the
but Kevin Owens able to kick Samoa Joe.
Kevin Owens putting it on him right now.
Dude, Samoa Joe is just getting destroyed. But Samoa Joe picks Owens up. Oh my god. And Owens is not out. I don't know what can put the man out. Huge knee to the face of Owens.
I can't help but think of his risk of internal injuries at this point in time. Yeah, this could get real serious.
But Kevin Owens able to kick Samoa. Kevin Owens, huge knee.
Samoa Joe really seems to have picked up some steam.
Great counter. Samoa Joe dealing out some punishment.
Yeah, too bad for his opponent.
Samoa Joe turns it around.
Oh, this guy's got a lot of moves.
Kevin, it's about to go huge suplex. Who? Kick out from Samoa Joe. How did he able to kick out?
When I tell you this guy is filled with it.
Okay, but it would have knocked out Samoa Joe. And his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack. And I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
Another great smack now. Thank you for choosing to join us tonight. Just trying to goad his opponent into making
Samoa Joe just taunting Owens. Samoa Joe missed the punch to Owens, but here comes Owens. Owens is down. Samoa Joe. Huge German suplex. Now he stays with it for the cover. One, two, kick out from Kevin Owens. Man, this match has been insane so far. Oh my god. Kevin Owens in the corner. Now he tries for a kick, but Samoa Joe moves outside of the ring. Samoa Joe tries to grapple Owens, but Owens gets let loose, and now Samoa Joe. Kevin Owens picks up Samoa Joe. Huge Samoa drop. Huge Samoa drop to Samoa Joe. And now, here's with a couple of one, two, no! Samoa Joe was able to kick out. Oh, boy. Now, Kevin Owens is trying to make Samoa Joe tap out, but Samoa Joe was able to grab it now. Samoa Joe grabs the head of Kevin Owens. Oh, it's a huge kick, and now grabs Samoa Joe, huge knee to the face. And now rolls him over. Now punch, tries to punch the elbow, but he just wasn't able to mount. Now huge suplex. Now Samoa Joe gets to come up, but Samoa Joe is able to put the man down. Now with the huge sweep, Kevin Owens, and now Kevin Owens tries to get Samoa Joe to tap out or do some of the sort, but Samoa Joe able to reverse it. Now Kevin Owens able to reverse. Kevin Owens hit the arm of Samoa Joe. Now Kevin Owens, as you get ready for the pop-up power bomb. No, pop-up power bomb. Now Kevin Owens goes for a cover. It's Samoa Joe out. It's Samoa Joe out. Yeah, but Samoa Joe, he would have break his way free. I cannot believe it. To be honest, I did not think Samoa Joe could kick out of that move. But he somehow did. Now, Kevin Owens catches the leg of Samoa Joe. Kevin Owens still up and Samoa down. Huge powerbomb from Samoa Joe in the corner. Now Samoa Joe. Huge punch it out, Samoa Joe. You go for the multiple three suplexes? Yep. Now he grabs it and another suplex. And you go back to the hands. And the third suplex. Two, three. We have a number one contender. We have a number one contender. And that the number one contender is Samoa Joe. Where the hell am I going? Samoa Joe. Picks up the win over Owens, and now he can finally get his hands on Nick's power like he's been wanting to do. Run up the block, Simon!
Big singles win here, guys. That'll knock Kevin Owens down a peg or two. And that'll do it here for this one-on-one matchup.
Well, I hope you guys did enjoy this episode. You guys said make sure to slam that like button down below. I'll see you guys next time. Peace. Oh my god, Tyler Breeze just ran in at Undertaker. Oh my god, I don't believe it, folks. Undertaker, the huge clothesline, the Breeze. I have no idea what just happened, folks. But Tyler Breeze just attacked. I thought that was over, but Tyler Breeze just attacked. SmackDown was over. I thought SmackDown was over. But Tyler Breeze just attacked Undertaker backstage. Oh my god, Undertaker just for being the phenom he is. I thought I was done, man. I finished. There's no more stuff left for me to say, really. Undertaker's just attacking Tyler Breeze. Now, I know this is Raw, everything, but we usually get prepared for Raw. And for some reason, you have Seth Rollins here tonight because of Raw Open Challenge. The SmackDown World Heavyweight Championship Open Challenge. So we had all the Raw superstars here. Now we're interviewing Seth Rollins about how he thinks SmackDown was, but guess like we won't be able to properly finish that interview with this Raw going on. These two men actually despise each other. They hate each other. That's how we shall drag Undertaker towards the wall of shame. Oh, Undertaker drags Tyler Breeze. No, Undertaker picks Tyler Breeze up for a last ride. No, but Breeze, it won't last. No, Breeze, hear about it. If that would have went through that table, that would have been detrimental for Undertaker's career, his 47-year-long career. Now, Taker's hurt. Taker's battered. Taker's battered and shattered. Now, Tommy's just trying to choke Undertaker. Tommy's briefcase, but no, briefcase. Briefcase doesn't come very long. I was gonna say it doesn't come good luck, but Tommy's hit him. Hit Undertaker with the briefcase right after. So I guess my words just chewed me up and spit me out. But here comes Undertaker. Try for another last ride suplex through that table. Oh my god! Breeze has a family, darn it. Now Taker tries to pick up the briefcase. Looks like he's not able to now Undertaker picks up a chair. And he was just putting a beat on Tyler Breeze. And we will see the end of this rivalry as it was just announced with SummerSlam. Tyler Breeze versus the Undertaker at WrestleSlam. SummerSlam just a week after today. We got one more SmackDown to continue. See what Undertaker does next. But I don't think either way it's going to be good for Breeze, because Breeze has been getting his butt whooped the past few days. And I don't know how Breeze really thinks about it. Undertaker picks Breeze up. No, no, Tombstone! Tombstone of Breeze! Hey! Oh my god, congratulations, Taker, but was it worth it?